PPR virus, it's a pestis ruminant virus, and it causes a severe disease known as PPR in small ruminants, particularly in the sheep and goat, and especially in the goats, it causes a severe disease. And this disease is also referred as goat plague, ovine rinderplague, pest, catarrh, syndrome of stomatitis, pneumoenteritis. But the FON and OIE, which is now known as a World Organization for Animal Health, uses the French name Pestis petits ruminants. And this disease is caused by the morbillivirus virus, and the virus name is Pestis petits ruminants virus, PPRV, and which is closely related to the other family members of the genus morbilliviruses viruses. And this virus is having four different lineages based on the sequence of the F protein, but there is only one serotype of this virus. And this virus causes high morbidity and high mortality in the affected animals. Coming to the transmission, for the transmission, close contact with the infected animals is required, and transmission generally occurs by the aerosol. In this disease, carrier stage is not known, but some clinical infections may occur, and the virus is excreted for the several days before the clinical symptoms of the disease, and which is facilitate the infection spread of the infection. And as I told, the disease is more severe in the goat, and the different breeds of the goats shows different morbidity rate. And generally, disease is more severe in young animals. Coming to its pathogenesis, first organism enters the body and multiplies in the oropharynx and the local lymphoid tissue of the host, and it causes infection of the immune cells, because these immune cells are the target for the virus multiplication. And subsequently, these results in viremia, leukopenia, and spread of the virus to different systemic organs occurs and causes the systemic infections. And this virus generally involves the lymphocyte, macrophage, dendritic cell, and epithelial cells of the alimentary tract. So the mucosal erosion and the profuse diarrhea are the common features of this disease. And in acute phase of the disease, virus is shed in all the secretions and the excretion of the body. It's a clinical sign. Generally, it causes a febrile response after the 2 to 8 days of infection. And affected animals show the fever, anorexia, dry muscle, and the serous nasal discharge later becomes pure mucocurulent. And the erosion of the mucous membrane of the buccal cavity is seen, and which is followed by the salivation. It also results in necrotic stomatitis and gingivitis. Gingivitis means inflammation of the gums. And the ulcer develops in the mucosa of the alimentary tract, respiratory tract, and the urinary tract. And conjunctivitis with ocular discharge is also caused in this disease. And it also results in the profuse diarrhea, which results in dehydration after few days of the infection. Tracheitis and pneumonia also develops in this disease. As this affects the immune cells, so the severe leukopenia causes, and this facilitate the secondary bacterial infections in the affected animals. And generally, the Pasteurella infection causing pulmonary infection is common in the later stage of the disease. If the animal is pregnant, abortion may occur, and the mortality rate is very high, and it may exceed more than 70% if the severe outbreak occurs. And the affected goats may die within the 10 days of the exposure to the virus. And course of the disease may be for acute, chronic, and it will depend upon the strain of the virus, age of the animal, immune status, and the breed of the host. on this it will depends that how the disease courses there. In sheep generally infection is subacute and it is characterized by the fever, nasal catarrh means the excessive discharge of the mucus from the nose occurs, and it also causes mucosal erosion and intermittent diarrhea. And generally affected animals, they usually recover within 10 to 14 days. Coming to the lesions, it causes extensive erosion and necrosis on the mucosal lining of the oral cavity, esophagus, and abomasum, and the small intestine. And the bran-like deposits are seen, which are the tiny necrotic ulceration or foci in the mucous membrane. And regional lymph nodes are enlarged. It also causes interstitial pneumonia. And in the characteristic in PPR, characteristic lesions are zebra strips or zebra marking, which are seen in the posterior part of the colon and the rectum, which are discontinuous streaks of the congestion, and it is typical for the PPR. In this picture, zebra stripping is seen in the large intestine, and here you can see the bran-like deposits on the oral mucosa. Coming to its diagnosis, disease can be diagnosed with the help of symptoms and lesions, but the confirmatory diagnosis requires isolation of the viruses or the antigen or antibodies detection. And for the diagnosis, suitable samples in the live animals are the nasal or ocular swab, blood, and the scraping of the buccal and rectal mucosa. And from the dead animal, PM samples like lung, spleen, and lymph node can be collected. And for the laboratory diagnosis, virus isolation can be done in the tissue culture. Antigen detection can be done by ELISA or immunoelectrophoresis, agar gel immunodiffusion. Antibodies detection can be done by the virus neutralization and the ELISA. And PCR means RT-PCR is also used for the diagnosis of virus nucleic acid. And coming to the control, in some countries which are free from the PPR, they consider the policies of slaughter and the movement restriction for the control of the disease. And where the disease is endemic, quarantine and the vaccination are generally practiced. And in India, Shingrix strain live-attenuated vaccine is practiced. And the first vaccination trial was done with the RP vaccination, Rinderpest vaccine. But now it is not practiced, as the disease is, Rinderpest disease is also eradicated. And presently, FOA and the World Organization for Animal Health are developed a global eradication program for the eradication of the PPR, and they have targeted to eradicate this disease by 2030. And these are some of the examples of the PPR vaccines. In India, PPR Shingrix 96 vaccine is used, which is of lineage 4 and of goat origin. Other than this, PPRV Nigeria 75/1 Nigeria, which is of lineage 2, goat origin vaccines. Others are also available from the sheep origin. And in India, another vaccine is Comirnaty 97, which is also of lineage 4 and goat origin vaccine. From Bangladesh, T2 lineage 4 goat origin vaccine is present. So, as total 6 attenuated PPR vaccines are available for the control of PPR. So, this briefly concludes the topic PPR. And if you are having any question, welcome. You can ask the questions.